Welcome. What you want to look at today is types of numbers. So, types of numbers is our main topic. Now for this, more videos like this, as well as CSEC Mathematics past papers, I'm going to invite you to visit the website mathematicsclass.org. That's mathematicsclass.org. mathematicsclass.org. Alright? So please visit that website for more videos, as well as solutions to CSEC Mathematics past papers and various examples of other mathematics videos. Now, types of numbers. What are the types of numbers? Different types of numbers. There is the natural numbers. Now, the natural numbers, these start at 1. So you have 1, 2, 3, and so on. Natural numbers, you will use those for counting. For example, if you're going to count the number of apples in a basket, you don't point to the first one and say 0. Say these are the apples, you don't point and say 0, 1, 2, 3. No, that's not what you do. You start 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 apples. So, naturally, you start at 4. Alright? Now, the next set of numbers that we want to look at is whole numbers. Whole numbers. Now these numbers actually start from 0 and contain only positive numbers. So you have 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So these are whole numbers. Then you have another set expanding the number of categories or the number of examples of numbers. We have integers. When it comes to integers, you include negative numbers plus the whole numbers. So you can say negative 3, there's negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. So you have negative 3 going down, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6, and so on. Or you can have from 3, after 3 going up, 4, 5, 6, and so on. Alright? So these are integers. When you have a number line, and you have 0 at the center of the number line, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and other numbers like that. On the right, and you have negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, it's negative 3, negative 2, these are negative, negative 5, and so on the left. So the number line, this number line contains integers. Now, there's another set of numbers you call rational numbers. So it's ratio, because it is in the form of a ratio. It's in the form of a ratio. Rational numbers. Now, Example. Let's say you have 3/5. That's a ratio. Sometimes you can write it as a ratio of 3 to 5. Alright. Another example might be 1/2, 1/2. What about the number 5? Is that a rational number? It is a rational number, because you can write it as 5 divided by 1. So it's a rational number just the same, right? What about 0.625? Is that a rational number? Yes, it is, because it can be written as 5/8. So it's a ratio of 5 to 8. So that is a rational number. Alright? Now, the next set of numbers that we will look at are not rational numbers. You have a certain name for them. They are called irrational numbers. And as you might guess, these cannot be written as a number divided by another number, as a whole number divided by another whole number. All right? Example. An example of an irrational number is the square root of 2. You cannot write down a whole number divided by another whole number and have that exactly equal to the square root of 2. So the square root of 2 is an irrational number. The square root of 3 is another irrational number. The square root of 5. These are irrational numbers. Right? It could be the cube root of 10. The fourth root of 21. These are irrational. So the square root of 2 is a number that multiplies itself to give it exactly 2. You cannot write that down as a whole number. Square root of 3, you have two numbers, same numbers multiplied to give you 3. You can't find that as a whole number. Same thing for the square root of 5. The cube root of 10 would be 3 of the same number that multiply themselves to give a 10. It's not a rational number. The 4th root of 21 are 4 of the same numbers that multiply to give you 21. If you try 2, 2 by 2 by 2 by 2, 2, 2, 4, 4, 2, 8, 8, 2, 16, it's more than 2. So try 3. 3 by 3 by 3 by 3. 3, 3 is 9, 9, 3 is 27, 27, 3, 81. It's somewhere between 2 and 3. But is not an exact whole number. Alright? The other set of numbers that we want to look at. Let me get some space up here. Now, that set of number, they call them imaginary numbers. So in other words, these are not real numbers. For example, what is the square root of -4? Which number is that? Now, some numbers might come to mind. Let's test them. If you try 2 times 2 gives you a positive 4, not negative 4. Alright, so it's not 2 and 2. Suppose you try negative 2 times negative 2. Remember, the square root supposed to multiply itself to give you the number. 2 times negative 2, does it multiply? Do they multiply to give you negative 4? No, they give you a positive 4, not a negative 4. So, it's not 2, it's not negative 2. You might say now, Suppose you multiply 2 times negative 2. What do they give you? Well, they give you negative 4. But guess what? The square root must be the same number. It multiplies itself. 2 and negative 2 are different numbers. So no matter how you take it, no matter what you do, no matter which direction you turn, you can't get out of it. It doesn't exist. The square root of negative 4 is not a real number. It's an imaginary number. Alright, so that will be it for types of numbers for today. We'll move on to another topic next time. So, I'll see you.